Hi, my name is Robert Feranek. I'm from FEDEVEL Academy, and in this video we are going to learn how to use Altium with Git, or to be specific, with GitHub. Now, what does it mean? Why we would like to learn this? What is Git? What is GitHub? Git is basically a software which will kind of create space for your project, where you can store your project and where you can track history of your project, where you can track all the changes in your project. And GitHub is a service which is using Git. And we are going to use GitHub because then you don't have to install Git on your computer or on your server. And GitHub is free for personal use, so if you would like to test what we are going to do in this video, feel free to register on GitHub and you can try it with your own project. Now, the advantage of using Git is, or GitHub, is that your project will be stored away from your computer. It means if something happened to your computer, your project, you still can download and you still can work with your project. Your project will be safe. If something happens in your company, or because there will be, I don't know, some virus which will lock all the files or something, this will not affect your project on GitHub. Again, you can continue working on your project on GitHub, no problem. So this is one of the advantages why you maybe would like to use Git, so it can store your project in some safe place. Then the other advantage of using Git is you can track changes. So when you make some changes in your project, you can comment or you can name these changes, and you can upload these changes to GitHub or to Git, and then you can very easily track what was actually happening in your project. Yeah, here is an example of my project. You can see different dates and you can see what I was doing. Capacitor corrected, first preliminary placement, CPU reposition for better memory layout. Okay, you can very easily track what was happening in your project. And if you would need, you can also see a specific stage of your project. So you can see your schematic before and after you were doing these specific changes. You can go back in your project to this specific stage, and also you can use Git with in collaboration. So if you have more engineers working on one project, it may be a little bit easier to Git can help you to manage this access of multiple engineers a little bit easier, maybe, to handle your project. It's not as for software development. Software development is much better, but you can use Git to manage also hardware projects, schematic and PCB within team or within more engineers and more people. This is everything what we will be speaking about in this video. So if you like, watch the video. If you like, you can follow this video and you can try everything by yourself. First, what you will need is an account on GitHub. So just Google for GitHub. Here is the main page and register. If you are already registered, then log into GitHub, go to your profile and select this, your repositories. Okay, this is the page what you will see. If you are new in GitHub, then you will not have any repositories. This will be empty. We are going to create a new repository. Repository is basically some kind of directory. So there will be your, that's the place where your project will be stored. So we need to create new repository. Click on this button. Here we are going to name the new repository. So I'm going to call it, for example, YouTube 28 pins. Here you would use a name of your project. And if you like, you can keep it public, but in this case, everyone whole world will have access to your project. Okay, so if you would like to keep your project private, then select this. I believe GitHub now has these private repositories enabled also for the free account, so you should be able to use private repository even if you are not paying anything. But I'm going to use this public. I'm going to call it YouTube 28 pins and create repository. So at this moment we have empty repository, there is completely nothing. If you go into your repositories, you should see it here, okay? If you click on this repository, it should be empty. Everything what you will need from this repository is this link, which is here. We will use it for our project. If you have never used Git before, then you need to install the software. Just Google for Git download, click on this first link, and download the software. Once you download the software, install the software. It's not difficult, just press next, 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 and finish. You don't really need to change anything what is set by default. Once you install the software, you need to run two more commands. So I'm going to Google for these commands. Git set name email. So you need to set your default name and default email. Click here. And these are the two commands what we need to use. To run Git, we are going to use command line. So if you are using older computer or older Windows, just write cmd and run this command line. Or if you are using Windows 10, you can use, I think they call it PowerShell, this Windows PowerShell. This is a little bit easier to use. You can simply copy and paste into this console. So we are going to set this name first. Use the name what you used when you registered on GitHub. So I'm going to copy it here. Oops. Control C, Control V, and I'm going to use my name here. Enter. And also set the email. Again, use the email what you used on your GitHub when you registered. Control C, Control V. Okay. Perfect. And we are almost ready. Basically, what we need to do now, we need to move to the directory where our project is located. So this is the directory where I have all the projects what I'm working on. It is eGitHub. I'm going to write E, enter, and now cd git tab, enter. We are in eGitHub. This is the directory where are all my projects, and we are going to clone, we are going to copy the repository from the GitHub, we are going to copy it here into this directory. At this moment the repository is empty, but we still would like to do it, okay? So go to our repository, here it is. This is the repository what we are going to use. Copy this line, you can just click here, copy it, go back into this command line and just write git clone and control V. This is the URL to our repository in GitHub. Enter. Okay, there is a warning, it appears that we cloned an empty repository, but it's fine. If we go into our directory, here it is. This is GitHub. This is the place with all my projects, and you can see there is this new directory which is ready for our Altium project. Now, everything what we need to do is we need to copy our current project. This is the current project on my local computer. You can see this is the directory. We need to copy this project into our new directory, which is going to be synchronized with GitHub. If you are not using Total Commander, of course, you can use the standard file explorer to copy the project. So I'm going to select all these files and I'm going to copy them to our new directory. Now, there are two extra files what I created, specially created. All these other files, they are standard. If we have a look, I'm going to show you what is inside of this. So this is a standard directory where I keep documents, and I would like to have these documents synchronized with GitHub. Here, inside of this directory, there is the Altium project with some other subdirectories. This is my standard README file, what I have in every directory of our company folder structure, or company project folder structure. But the extra files, two extra files, what I have here in this project is this README file and gitignore. I'm going to show you what is inside of these two files. Basically, this README.md file, it is a very simple file which you can use to describe your repository. When I open it, there is nothing else, just some text. Okay, and you can use special formatting for this text. It is called markup. If you Google for GitHub markup code, here you can find more information how you can format the text in the GitHub. Once we upload these files to GitHub, I will show you how this file looks, how you can use it. So this is very simple. This is just a README file, but this one is more interesting. In this .ignore file, you can specify what files and directories you don't want to upload to GitHub. Because, you know, sometimes in your project there may be some temporary files or some files which are only used by some softwares which you really don't want to track because they are not really your project. For example, if you are using Altium, then there are always these previews and history directories which they keep changing because Altium is using these directories, but you really don't want to track the changes inside of these directories. You would like to ignore these directories when your project is uploaded to GitHub. So inside of this gitignore file, you can specify these files and directories. When I open this file, at this moment it is empty because I would like to show you how you can find out what everything is going to be uploaded to GitHub and how you can then actually specify the files and directories here, and then we will check again what is going to happen, what files and directories Git will upload actually to GitHub. So at this moment it is empty, and I'm going to show you how we are going to see what Git would like to upload to GitHub. Let's go to our command line, or to our PowerShell, and we need to move to the directory where our project is located. So I'm going to write cd YouTube 28 pins. Okay, be sure you are in your project directory. And now we can run some git commands. First command what we are going to try is git status. This will tell you the status in what this directory is currently. And this what we can see here, these red files and red directories, it means these are the files and directories what have been changed. Now, to actually upload this directory to GitHub, we need to run a couple of commands. First, we are going to specify what files we would like to upload to GitHub. Then we are going to commit these changes, and we will add the message what actually happened or why these changes were made. And after that, only after that, we will push or upload these changes to GitHub. So first, what we need to do, we need to add these, or we need to specify what we would like to later upload to GitHub. And to, in the command, how you tell what files you would like to upload to GitHub is called git add. Now you can say, or you can specify exactly the files and directories what you would like to upload, or you can use dot. Dot, it means we would like to upload all the files and directories what have been changed. We would like to upload all the changes. Okay, now let's run git status. And wow, okay, these are all the changes what happened in our project directory, but we don't want to upload all these files. We were speaking about this. So what are we going to do? We are going to exclude, for example, this history directory, or we would like to exclude this project directory. We would like to exclude this previous directory. How we are going to do it? We are going to specify this in git ignore file. So I'm going to open this and I'm going to put there something like this. So inside of this dot git ignore file, I put the names of the directories and files what we don't want to upload. Previous, history, and all the files and directories with these words are going to be ignored. I'm going to save this. Okay, let's go back into console. We would like to reset the status. So write git reset. We would like to go back, step back, okay. Git status. Okay, we are at the beginning. And we would like to add these files again, but this time the dot git ignore file will be used. So when we use this git add all command, we will not add all the files and directories which are here in this R project directory. We will only add the files which are not ignored. Press enter, git status. Okay, much better. This is exactly what we would like to upload to GitHub. Now, in the next step, when you are happy with this, these are the files what we would like to upload. In the next step, we would like to run command which is called commit, git commit, and you can add message. You can add some description which will describe why or what kind of changes were made in these files. For this first commit, I'm going to use like initial commit message. This is the message what you will see later when we will be checking the history of our project. You will see. Okay, and now is the right time to upload all these files what has changed. We are going to upload it to GitHub, and this is the command what we need to run. Git push origin master, enter. Now git may ask for your name or password, so you may need to put it there, but my name and password, it has already been saved, so it doesn't ask me. And perfect, everything what we have to do now is we need to check our GitHub. I went to our project git directory, and I'm going to refresh this directory. Or to be precise, it's not called directory, it is repository. Let's have a look, what do we have here. This is the readme.md file. This is the extra file what I copied to our project, and I promised you to show you how it looks. So this is the original file. This is the original text inside of the file, and this is how it looks when you see it on GitHub. So all this formatting, what you can see here, this is what is happening. Yeah, this is the heading. Okay, these are these numbers which are here. And as I said, if you would like to know more about the formatting, you can just Google for the GitHub markup. It's very nice to add the README MD file to your project, because it makes your project look more professional, and you can put there quick links or some notes what other people can use. Then here we can see the project itself. So this is the Altium project, only with the files what we would like to upload to GitHub. And what is also very interesting is this commit here. When I click here, later you will see the history of your project. I will show you an example a little bit later. But the first commit what we made was called initial commit, and that's what we can see here. Okay, now we are ready to actually start Altium, and I'm going to show you how you can work with GitHub in Altium. Start Altium software, go to File, Open Project, Browse, eGitHub. So this is the place with all our projects. Here is our project. I'm going inside of the project, and I'm going to open our board. Now, watch these icons which are here. This green check, it means this file is up to date. I'm going to open schematic, and we are going to make a change in the schematic. I'm going to delete this C3 capacitor. Watch what is going to happen here in these icons. White icon here, it means we open the document. When I delete this C3 capacitor, we are going to make some changes in the document. So I'm going to delete it. This has changed to red. It means we have made changes in the document, but the changes have not been saved. I'm going to save the changes and watch what is going to happen here. This is again white, but the green check is gone. Now there is this red circle. Red circle means we have made some changes in this document, but we have not committed these changes yet. We have not described these changes. And because we would like to track the history of the changes, I'm going to describe what we have done. So I'm going to do right click on this project, version control, commit whole project. You can nicely see we made changes in this document, and I'm going to describe the changes. So we deleted C3 capacitor. Now down here you have two options. We can only commit the changes locally, or we can commit the changes and we can also push all the changes to GitHub. You don't have to always push all the changes to GitHub. You can very easily just use this commit. And that's what we are going to do. Okay, so this first time we are not going to push the changes, we are going to only describe the changes. Select commit and watch this icon. It has been changed again. Instead of this green check, now there is green clock. It means we have committed the changes, but these changes have not been uploaded to GitHub yet. If we go to GitHub, when I refresh this page, watch this number of commits. There is still only one commit what we made manually. It is the initial commit. Okay. Let's go back into our schematic. We are going to make another change. I'm going to delete C4. So watch the icons here. We are going to save this document. So this document has been changed. We need to commit, or we need to describe the changes what we made. Right click, version control, commit whole project. We deleted C4. And this time, I'm not only going to commit the changes, I'm going to commit and also push the changes. So what is going to happen? You know? In our GitHub repository, after we commit and push the changes from Altium, this number of commits will increase. There will be 3 commits. What kind of commits will be here? The first one will be the initial commit. The second commit will be deleted C3, and the third commit will be C4 deleted. So let's do it. Go back to Altium and commit and push. You need to put here your GitHub username and password. And press OK. Open our GitHub repository again and refresh. Watch what is going to happen here. You immediately see there are 3 commits, and also down here you can see this is the last change what we made in our project, C4 deleted. If I click on this commit, you can see the initial commit was yesterday, and today we made these 2 changes. Yes. Now, when you make changes in Altium, you don't have to always do the commit. So you can make multiple changes, you can save the project as many times as you want. And once you kind of make the group of changes what you can easily describe, only after then you can commit the changes. And when you commit the changes, you don't have to be connected to internet. So this is advantage of using Git. All these commits can be done locally. So you can travel or something, you can work on your project, you can commit the changes. So always when you make some changes, you can describe what you have done. And once you are connected to internet, then you can upload all these commits and changes at once. Now, I would like to show you something else. I would like to show you how you can easily compare the changes. Let's say we would like to see what were the changes between specific versions of this schematic page, between the initial commit and the current stage, for example. So right click on this schematic page, local history, storage manager. Here, be sure you select the schematic page because you would like to see the history of this specific file. And down here, oops, you can see all the commits, all the versions of this file. This is the initial commit, and this is the current open document. So I'm going to select this initial commit, press Ctrl on your keyboard. We would like to compare it with currently open document. Now right click and compare. This differences panel will automatically open. And here you will see a list of differences between these 2 documents. This is the current document, and this is the document. This is the initial document from this specific revision. Let's have a look what are the differences. I'm going to just left click on this first difference, which is here, and it will kind of highlight, or it will select this extra document which was in this initial document, this capacitor, and you can see here this capacitor is not located. Next change, C4 capacitor, again you can see it here, but it's not here. This is the ground symbol which was connected to the capacitor, and this is also ground symbol connected to the capacitor. So this way you can kind of easily find the changes. It's not always so easy, it's not always so visible, but it can be useful when you can very nicely and simply compare the specific versions of a file. Now we are going to try something interesting. Let's say there is someone else working with you on the same project. We would like to see what will happen when this someone else will make changes. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a different directory, like different user, and we will copy the project from GitHub also to this directory, and we will open it also in Altium, and we will make the changes in Altium. Let's see what will happen. So I'm going to run the PowerShell. Okay. Okay, we are in this directory. Let's go and copy the URL from our project. I copied this. We are going to clone the GitHub directory for this different user. Okay, we should see it here, perfect. And we are going to open this in Altium. Now we have two users working on the same project, which is in GitHub. This one is using different directory, or in real world, this one would be working on his or her own computer, and this one would be working on his or her own computer in different location. And this one is editing the 28-pin schematic page, and this user is going to edit, for example, block diagram. So I'm going to open block diagram page, and let's delete this. Save the changes. Right click, version control, commit whole project. Block diagram updated, and I'm going to commit and push the changes. Let's go back to this different user, right click on this project, version control, refresh. Watch what is going to happen with these icons which are here. So right click, version control, refresh. This is really cool, no? This engineer, he can very nicely see, because there is this orange clock now, he can very nicely see that this page has been updated by someone else. I'm going to close this block diagram. And to update this schematic page, I'm going to right click here, version control, update. Okay, now when I open this block diagram, it has been updated, and this engineer can now very nicely see all the changes what were made by this other engineer. Yes, yes. What if both engineers make changes on the same page? I'm going to open this page here. I'm going to delete this picture. Save it. I'm going to open it here. I'm going to delete this. Save it. I'm going to commit the changes. Push them to GitHub. And let's see what will happen when I refresh the project here. This icon has changed. This means there is a conflict. You need to decide which version you would like to use, because this is the version with 28 pins deleted. And this one, when I open it, this is the version where I deleted this picture. So which one we would like to use? I'm going to close this. I'm going to right click on this cover page, version control, and let's say I would like to use the version what is on GitHub. So I'm going to discard all the local changes. Yes. Okay. So now basically this file is the original file. You see, here is the picture. And everything what we have to do, we just need to update this file to get the changes from GitHub. So right click, version control, update. When I open it now, what will be inside of this file? The 28 pins should be missing. Okay, 28 pins. So this cover page is now exactly same as this one from this other engineer. What if we would like to do it the other way around? So what if this engineer, if he or she will make some changes, I'm going to make changes in revision history. I'm going to save it. And also this other engineer will make changes. And let's say I'm going to copy it here. I'm going to save this. Push it into GitHub. Okay, refresh this. What if this engineer would like to keep this version and push this version of his file to GitHub? What to do then? Simple way to handle this situation is be persistent. Push and commit as many times as it is needed. Right click, version control, commit whole project. History updated. You see, there is a conflict, so let's see what will happen. Update whole project. We would like to use the local. Yeah, we would like to push into GitHub this version of file from this engineer. So keep local. just ignore this. Okay, there is still the conflict, but let's do the commit one more time and now it will work. I don't really know why we need to do it this way. If you know, leave a comment, okay? Keep local. Perfect. The conflict has been resolved. Now, in GitHub, we have this version of the file. We can go back into this other engineer. This one still has this specific version, but this engineer would like to now download the updated version from GitHub. So you can close this. You don't have to close this page if you don't want to. It will be automatically updated. But I like to close it because it's then easier. But okay, let's don't close it. Right click, version control, refresh. Right click, version control, update. See, it has been automatically updated. If I go here, this is the page. If I go here, this is the page. Yes. There is only one more thing what we would like to learn, and it is about how to revert the changes. Let's say we made a mistake. We really would like to have these capacitors back. Right click on the schematic page, local history, storage manager. Click on the schematic page. Click on version 1. This is the original version with all the capacitors. Right click, revert to. And we have the version with capacitors. Now what you can do, you can simply just right click, version control, refresh, right click, version control, commit all project. Right click, refresh, right click, update. Now both engineers, they have the original version of the schematic with all the capacitors. And now you will dream about push and commit and refresh and GitHub and more engineers working on one project. This may sound maybe a little bit complicated for someone who is new in Git, but if you are not sure or if it looks a little bit confusing, maybe rewatch the video again and I'm sure you will understand what I was explaining and how the workflow may work in your project. In most cases, you don't really will be in these situations when you need to solve the conflicts between more engineers. In many cases, you may be using this Git only by yourself. That's what I usually do. I'm usually only the one engineer. And most of the cases, what I do is just write the comment of the changes, so I do the commit and then I do the push, and that's everything. And that's very easy to that's a very easy way how you can use Altium with GitHub. No confusions. More complicated it will become when more engineers start working on the same project. Okay, please leave comments, okay? I'm really interested to know what do you think about this kind of approach, or if you use Git, or how you do it. If you like this video, don't forget press like button. I would like to thank you very much for watching, and see you next time. Bye.